ಸಂಗತಿಗಳ ಜ್ಞಾನದೀಪ.
ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಬಸವಲಿಂಗಾಯ ನಮಃ. ನೋಡಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ಇಂದಿನ ಸಂಚಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭೌತಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಡ್ಯುವಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋನ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋನ್ಡಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಫೈವ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫೈವ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್. ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಜ್ಞಾಪಕ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವನ್ ದಿ ನೋಬೆಲ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಒನ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ದಿ ನೋಬೆಲ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್. ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಆಫ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವಿಟಿ, ಥಿಯರಿ ಆಫ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್, ಫೇಮಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್, ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಸಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ನಾ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಸಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಬಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಆಫ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಲಿಟ್ಲ ಹೈ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಬಟ್ ಹೀ ಗಾಟ್ ದಿ ನೋಬೆಲ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್. ದಟ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಐಲ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್, ಗಿವ್ ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಐಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಿಸನ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಇಸ್, ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್, ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್, ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್, ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್, ಸೇ ದರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್, ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ಫೋಟಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್. ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್, ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್. ನೋಡಿ ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿನಲ್ಲೇ ಓದಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್. ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್. ನೋಡಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ನೀವು ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರಲ್ಲೇ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೀರಾ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಬೋತ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್. ಇನ್ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೊಮೆಂಟಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ ದಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್, ಕೊಲಿಜನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕೊಲಿಜನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್. ಸಿ ದಿ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ದ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕೊಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಫೋಟಾನ್, ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಲಿಬರೇಟ್, ಈಸ್ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್, ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಲಿಬರೇಟ್, ಟು ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ದಿ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಟು ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ದಟ್ ಟು ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪುಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ, ಯು ರೈಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಫ್ ಇ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಫೋಟಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ಫೈ ನಾಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್, ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ಫೈ ನಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ದಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇ ಕೆ ಈಸ್ ದಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇ ಕೆ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಫೈವ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೈವ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇ ಕೆ. ನಾವು ಫರ್ದರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟು ಸೇ, ನಾ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ ದಿ, ಇಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಇಫ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್, ನ್ಯೂ ನಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಥ್ರೆಶೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಕೇಸ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹೆಚ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ನ್ಯೂ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಎಮ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಮೈನಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ನ್ಯೂ ನಾಟ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಎಮ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪುಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ರೆಕ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್, lambda is the wavelength of the incident radiation, and lambda naught is the wavelength. Then we can replace this nu by hc by lambda equals hc by lambda minus hc by lambda naught equals half mv square. This can also be called as Einstein's photoelectric equation. One is h nu minus h nu naught equals half mv square, and the other one is hc by lambda equals hc by lambda minus hc by lambda naught equals half mv square. Now here, if it is given for 5 marks, for 3 marks it will be enough, and if you say this much it will be enough. If they ask for 5 marks, you have to say some 3 more things. Say one case, one first, you put like, if nu is greater than nu naught, if nu is greater than nu naught, you can write like kinetic energy is positive. Definitely observe this here. When nu is greater than nu naught, h nu minus h nu naught must be positive. That is, kinetic energy is positive. Inference also you write. What is inference means? If nu is greater than nu naught, Ek is positive. Andre photoelectric effect agutte, jothege liberated electron ge kinetic energy irutte. Meaning of which is, photoelectric effect takes place first. Photoelectric effect takes place, and the liberated photoelectron will move with a certain kinetic energy. This much you have to write here, first point. Second point is, if nu equals nu naught, Ek must be zero. Ek must be zero, because you observe this here, if nu equals nu naught, h nu minus h nu naught is zero, half mv square. What is the conclusion here means? Again you say photoelectric effect takes place, but the kinetic energy of the liberated photoelectron is zero. That means that electron will not be having any velocity to move. And finally, one more here. If nu is less than nu naught, see, just observe. Neeve observe madile, Ek must be negative. If nu is less than nu naught, work function will be more, energy supplied is less, kinetic energy should be negative, meaning of which is photoelectric effect does not take place. And so this much you are supposed to write. See here once again, what is Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect means? According to Einstein, collision between photon and electron is an elastic collision. Now according to Einstein, the energy of the incident photon is utilized to liberate the electron and as well as to provide the kinetic energy. That is, you have to write like this. If E is the energy of the incident photon, phi is the, or phi naught, in any way you can, if you want you can take, phi naught is the work function and Ek is the kinetic energy, you can write it as E equals phi naught plus Ek. Next step, just a little, you have to explain these things. If nu is the frequency of incident radiation, nu naught is the threshold frequency, v is the velocity of the liberated photoelectron, it will be h nu equals h nu naught plus half mv square. Just what I am doing, h nu minus h nu naught equals half mv square. Next, we are putting the same thing in terms of wavelength, threshold wavelength. You know, nu naught already you have explained. And again, lambda naught, it is a threshold wavelength. Hc by lambda minus hc by lambda naught equals half mv square. And now these different cases, when nu is greater than nu naught, what happens? When nu is equal to nu naught, what happens? Amale nu less than nu naught adre enagutte, just you will explain madbeku. This is Einstein's photoelectric equation. And you see here, even sometimes this kinetic energy, even I can put it as kinetic energy equals h nu minus h nu naught, that is phi naught also I can say. Now here, this Ek in terms of potential, stopping potential, I can write it as E V naught. If I write this as E V naught here, E V naught equals h nu minus phi naught. And now I can put V naught equals h nu by E minus phi naught by E. Observe this. Say Ek equals kinetic energy is h nu minus phi naught. Ek is nothing but E into V naught. V naught is stopping potential. E is the charge on the electron. So then E V naught equals h nu minus phi naught. And V naught equals divide throughout by E. And now here you say, in case if I plot a graph of V naught versus frequency, V naught versus frequency, say V naught versus, always you know, whenever I say V naught versus, V naught should be on y axis and nu must be on x axis. You know, in first year also we are using, since from first year, velocity time curve means velocity must be plotted along y-axis, time is along x-axis. If I plot a graph of V naught versus nu, you will get one straight line here, one straight line like this. Say this part is taken as nu naught. Why nu naught means, until this no photoelectric effect, no photoelectric effect. So here and again here, this is, if you extrapolate this curve where it touches the y-axis, that is nothing but phi naught, that is a work function. This is potential versus this. And again, if I take a slope here, that slope is nothing but h by e, and I can write this as y equals mx plus c. Observe this, m is like h by e here and c is like minus phi naught by e, that is a constant. Here this can be taken as minus phi naught by e, and in case if we are writing ek versus nu, we write just phi naught and slope will be Planck's constant. Know this. And so this is about Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect. See, problems and all probably we will try to see later, and some problems I will be showing. A problems part saha ellaru tumba tough anta ankoltira. First you should know what is the formula and which formula to be applied. See, normally in mathematics and all probably you might have seen, most of the time we will ask differentiate, integrate, there is a clarity in the question only. But here you have to read the question and you have to analyze the data, and then you have to write. We will see those things, problems and all we will be seeing later. First let me complete further things. Now you see, we will go for dual nature of matter. So you'll get it, dual nature of matter. Then normal age, yavde college alle, no. What is dual nature of matter? And the students immediately they'll say, light behaves like a particle and as well as wave. No doubt, light behaves like a particle and as well as wave. But I am asking about dual nature of matter. That is dual nature of light. Why the dual nature of light has come into existence means, a little I'll be talking about it. You see, first theory on light has been proposed by Newton. Newton's corpuscular theory in and around 1675 he proposed. He says light is a particle. Light consists of minute particles called corpuscles. And now next, around 1678, almost in the same some 3 years or so, Huygens proposed one more theory. He says light travels in the form of waves, but you know, all of you know very well, light is a wave, but it is a longitudinal wave and it is a mechanical. At that time only that concept was there. Mechanical means light requires material medium for propagation and it is a longitudinal wave. Later, around 1870, Maxwell, he proposed one more theory. He says light is a wave only, but whereas it is not a longitudinal, it is a transverse wave, it is a non-mechanical, it can travel even in vacuum. And finally in 1900, Max Planck, he says light is not a wave and it behaves like a particle. Emission or absorption of radiation, it always takes place in discrete packets of energy called quanta. You know, every one of you are aware of it. Energy associated with each quanta is nothing but h nu. H is the Planck's constant, nu is the frequency of the radiation. Now you say, Newton says it is a particle, Huygens says it is a wave, Maxwell says it is a wave but it is transverse, and as well as it is a non-mechanical wave, but Max Planck says it is a particle again. So now scientists started accepting one more, that is dual nature of light. Dual nature of light. What do you mean by dual nature of light means, it doesn't mean like sometimes it behaves like a particle and sometimes it behaves like a wave. Certain phenomenon can be better understood by considering light as a particle, and certain other phenomenon can be better understood by considering light as a wave. Andre ondashtu phenomenon no light na particle anta tagondo explanation kotre chenaga artha madkobodu, innondashtu phenomenon no light na wave anta tagondre chenaga artha madkobodu, adu meaning. Iga one more scientist by name de Broglie, kelidana de Broglie, he suggested that, you see, initially he suggested just, he has taken like this, de Broglie suggested that when light which was considered as a wave for that long, say nearly 1678 to 1900, we took it as a wave, whether it is a longitudinal or transverse, we assumed this as a wave only, but now suddenly we are accepting it as a particle. That means when light, which was considered as a wave, when it behaves like a particle, he thought, why can't a particle like electron exhibit wave nature? It's just a converse of it. Why can't a particle like electron exhibit wave nature? That's very true. See, these people are all applying symmetry. We say in the universe, symmetry exists. When something is behaving in the other way, other part should also be there. He thought like particles like electron must also exhibit wave nature. This is. And again, one more thing here. You see, the name of the scientist, usually I'll be providing this knowledge. The name of the scientist is actually Brawley. We have seen De Morgan, De Morgan. You know, name of the scientist is actually Morgan. Observe here. I am writing DE with small letter, B with capital letter. This D here, it is given for the French people, a respect. De Broglie, De Morgan. Just this out of the syllabus, but whereas, try to know about this. This is De Broglie and De Morgan. But now, what De Broglie has done is, an equation he had given. That was his concept. Later, other scientists have worked on that, and they have done many wonders. So now here, very first, De Broglie, this is De Broglie waves or matter waves. Matter waves are De Broglie waves. Come on, observe this. Waves, matter waves are De Broglie waves. This can be given for 1 mark. What are De Broglie waves or matter waves? What to write? Nodi, adhen thumba tough enalla. Simple sentence. The waves which are associated with material particles which are in motion. See here, I need these words. The waves which are associated with material particles which are in motion. See, these two points are important. This is material particle and this is motion. Once again, the waves which are associated with material particles which are in motion are called matter waves or De Broglie waves. Now one more is De Broglie wavelength. De Broglie wavelength. What is De Broglie wavelength means? The wavelength associated with the material particles which are in motion. Same way, the wavelength which is associated with material particles which are in motion is called De Broglie wavelength. Now, one equation. This equation is important for 2 marks. Arrive at De Broglie wave equation. Arrive at De Broglie wave equation. Can be made as 3 marks. In such a case, how we give the question is, what are De Broglie waves? Or what is De Broglie wavelength? Obtain an expression for De Broglie wavelength. Or arrive at De Broglie wave equation. See the question. I need not write every time. Arrive at De Broglie wave equation. Or even we can ask, show that lambda equals h by p. Show that lambda equals h by p. See now, this derivation, simplest derivation. Now what he says, according to Max Planck's quantum theory, according to Max Planck's quantum theory, 2 sentences enough. According to Max Planck's quantum theory, we have, you write like this, E equals h nu, and explain the terms, put it as equation 1, and then say what is h and what is nu. You know very well, h is a Planck's constant, nu is frequency of radiation. Now further, you can tell like, we know that nu equals c by lambda. Nu equals c by lambda. You see, in first year waves, we have seen v equals f lambda. Can be written as, always remember, c equals nu lambda. This is in waves, v equals f. Symbol we are using f. But here in electromagnetic waves, we will put c. C equals nu lambda. Then what will be nu equals means? It is nothing but c by lambda. Now here, substituting for this, you will get E equals hc by lambda. This call it as 2. Now, according to Einstein's mass energy relation, we know very well, it is a very famous relation. I told already, E equals mc square. Now, comparing these two equations, we will get mc square equals hc by lambda. Mc square equals hc by lambda. Now one C you cancel, see here, one C you cancel, and what is lambda equals? H by mc. Mc is nothing but momentum of the photon. Mc is nothing but we write momentum, momentum of the photon. Better thing what I suggest is, don't stop here. You say, for any other material particle, because wavelength, de Broglie wavelength, we are talking about material particles, matter waves means. For any other material particles which is moving at the velocity v, velocity v, this equation becomes lambda equals h by mv. See, for any other material particle which is moving with a velocity, which is moving with the velocity v, lambda equals h by mv. Now, I can write this as, this also one equation, or even you can say mv is nothing but p, momentum. So, we write, therefore, what we write is lambda equals h by p. And so, this is the de Broglie's wave equation. See, once again here, just according to Max Planck's quantum theory, we have E equals h nu, and where h is Planck's constant and nu is frequency of radiation. And then we know that nu equals c by lambda. You need not show that how to get it. And if you remember, aste saku, nu equals c by lambda, illi E equals h c by lambda anta bariyodu. Next, according to that, you have to mention, according to Einstein's mass energy relation, you have to write E equals mc square. And comparing these two, or from equations 2 and 3, even you can put like this, from equations 2 and 3, from equations 2 and 3, mc square equals hc by lambda, and you can cancel c, and lambda equals h by mc. And I told mc is momentum of the photon, but still what I am suggesting, you write like, for any other material particle which is moving with velocity v, then lambda will be equal to h by mv. And mv equals p, and therefore it will be lambda equals h by p. I hope you understood this. So now further, there are two different forms of de Broglie wave equations. We'll see that. What are these different forms of wave equations? You see here, two different forms of de Broglie wave equations. One is, if an electron or any other particle, any charged particle, for any other charged particle, if Ek is the kinetic energy, if Ek is the kinetic energy, derivation is not important, just observe. We can write Ek equals, always we write half mv square. Multiplying both sides, this is equation 1, multiplying both sides with m, we get mek equals half m square v square, half m square v square. See here, this mv is nothing but momentum. So, what can I write here? Mek, take this 2 also this side, equals p square. Since observe, mv is nothing but p. Then what is p equals means? Root of 2mek. P equals root of 2mek. In such a case, what will be lambda? Lambda is h by p. H by p means, I write h by root of 2mek. And so, this is one of the equation. Lambda equals h by root of 2mek. Come and try to remember this. You need not even write, but you should have this knowledge. So, this is lambda equals h by root of 2mek. So, now you see. Now, one more equation. You know, Ek is nothing but, Ek is nothing but Ev. Ek is nothing but E into V. Can be expressed in terms of electron volts. What is electron volt means? Later also I will be seeing, now also I will be telling. Electron volt means the energy gained by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. So, even generally, I can write Ek as QV, Ek as QV. In such a case, lambda becomes h by root of 2m QV, h by root of 2m QV. Say, this is one equation and this is the second equation. These two equations you try to remember. And again here, lambda depends on charge, lambda depends on mass, lambda depends on potential. And here, lambda depends on mass and as well as Ek. But observe this here. Here, lambda is inversely proportional to mass. And in case if I am taking this, lambda equals h by mv, we say here, sometimes in competitive exams, will be telling, when they give constant velocity, we say lambda is inversely proportional to m. But when they say constant kinetic energy, I say lambda is inversely proportional to 1 by root m. Sometimes some students might be getting a doubt, why sir is taking in one place, lambda is inversely proportional to m, and here inversely proportional root m. Be careful here. When I'm talking about velocity constant, you have to take lambda will be inversely proportional to mass. And when I say kinetic energy is constant, then it will be lambda is inversely proportional to 1 by root m. If I say V is constant, V is kept constant, then lambda is inversely proportional to root m and as well as q also, depends on both mass and as well as charge. Come on, I hope you have got a clarity about this, only equations and again how to take these things. Now further here, further, for an electron, when an electron is accelerated through a potential difference of V volts, this will be helpful for competitive exams also and as well as for board exam, what to write. See here, I am telling lambda equals h by, one formula I had given, root of 2m qv. If it is an electron, for an electron accelerated through the same potential difference V, then what to write is lambda equals, I have to write like h by root of 2m ev. Remember this, lambda equals h by root of 2m ev. And further you say, now let me say, I say like an electron has been accelerated through a potential difference of 100 volts, what is the wavelength? See here, I had to substitute for h, I had to substitute for mass, I had to substitute for e, and then for 100, you have to get the answer. Rather than that, we have got, by calculating these values and finding out h by root m, root 2me, I can put this as 12.27 by root v angstroms. 12.27, what is the meaning of this? E values, so h value substitute maadi, mass substitute maadi, electron substitute maadi, root tagondu calculate maadidre 12.27. or even same thing, we put it as 1.227 divided by root v nanometer. I hope nimge ee difference gotagta ide. 1 angstrom is 10 power minus 10 meter. 1 angstrom is 10 power minus 10 meter. Nanometer means, 1 nanometer means it is 10 power minus 9 meters. So you can have 12.27 by root v angstroms or 1.227 by root v nanometer. Come on, you see here. Now if I put the same question, what is the wavelength of the electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 100 volts? Just put 100 here. Root 100 is 10. 12.27 by 10 is nothing but what? 1.227 angstroms. See how simple it has become. And then here, if you want, if you put this as 100, it will become 0.1227 or even 0.123 nanometer you can take. And so this way you have to calculate. This will be very much helpful in, especially in competitive exams, CET and as well as JEE main and all. So now one more, suppose in case I am giving, for the same formula I am giving, it has been accelerated through around some 600 volts or 150 only you take. Just a 150 volts, around 150 volts, what will be the value? As it is, no delay, 12.27 divided by root 150, 12.27 divided by root 150 angstroms or 1.227 by root V nanometer. V is 150, how to take root of it? Root 150, here you can use calculator, you can do it, but whereas in competitive exams you are not supposed to. See, in a way, just simple idea. 12 square 144, 13 square 169, 12 square is 144, 150 is slightly more than 12, slightly more than 12 means root 150 more than 12, you can cancel and you can put it as 1 angstrom. See here, it will be helpful. Now one more I will be telling, how to convert the same thing for proton, for alpha particle, at least for proton and alpha particle, we will see. In case if I ask lambda p, what to write in a h by root of 2mp qp v. Qp is nothing but qe. Qp is nothing but qe. Now mass of the proton, we can go ahead, that is a different thing. Mass of the proton is 1836 times mass of the electron. 1836 times mass of the electron. Charge is same. The value what you are getting for electron divided by root 1836, you will be getting the answer. Okay, that will be around 0.285 you will be getting. But whereas for alpha particle, if I ask lambda alpha particle, nodi alpha particle andre nimgella gottide, It is nucleus of what? Helium. What do you mean by nucleus of helium means? Helium nucleus will be having two protons and two neutrons and two electrons will be revolving around the nucleus. If I consider a whole system, it will become helium atom. And if I remove these electrons, it will become He plus plus. This is only we'll call it as alpha particle. 2 into m alpha q alpha. Here you have to be careful. Q alpha is plus 2e. M alpha is approximately 4 times mp. Then whatever you are getting for proton, in that you will be getting. Here, let me say, this is lambda equals h by root of 2 into 4 mp. 2 into 4 mp into q alpha 2 qp v. I can write this as h by root of 8 times into 2 mp qp v. You know, this root and all everything, it is nothing but lambda p. That is nothing but lambda p. And then this lambda alpha will be lambda p by 2 root 2. So have these ideas, because sometimes even in board exam we'll be asking some questions. When the particles like electron, proton and alpha particle, come and observe this, particles like electron, proton and alpha particle are subjected to same potential difference, which will be having more wavelength. Obviously here you have to check all these things and you can find out. That will be lambda will be more for electron, because mass of the electron is very less. And even sometimes we can ask them to arrange in ascending order or descending order. This is about just dual nature of matter and as well as de Broglie wave equation and different form of de Broglie wave equations, how to write lambda in terms of v. Now see, this has been proposed by de Broglie and later some people have proved. Say what de Broglie suggested is, once again I am telling, when light which was considered as a wave, when it behaves like a particle, why can't particle like electron exhibit wave nature? So now we have to prove that electrons exhibit wave nature. So for this one very, very important experiment you have, that is Davison-Germer experiment. See, this experiments also you can score out of out, no problem. See, Davison-Germer experiment, what is the main purpose of this means? To prove that electrons exhibit wave nature. What method they adopted is, we know and as well as you too know, diffraction, interference diffraction. This diffraction is the sure property for wave nature. Now what we are going to show is, light exhibits diffraction phenomenon. Light exhibits diffraction phenomenon. If I show that electron also exhibit diffraction phenomenon, very easy to conclude. Say, light waves exhibit diffraction. To exhibit diffraction, they must have a wave property. Now if I show like electron also exhibit diffraction, that means what? Electron also exhibit wave nature. I hope nimge artha aagthide anta anusute. Illi nodi, light diffraction phenomenon exhibit madutte anta andre it is a wave. If I show electron saha diffraction phenomenon exhibit madutte anta torusidre, it is like it also exhibit wave nature. For this they have taken one experiment. See, experiment sometimes you might get confused, but of course figure you have to write. Label that figure. Figure means whatever is there you just write, and then explanation of the arrangement, and then what exactly we have to do. Few things, not in complete detail, you see what exactly you are supposed to write in the examination, that I'll be showing. See here, what we consider first, one electron gun will be taking. It is connected to a low tension. Say this figure will be writing like this. Here it is, figure is just one filament. This is a filament, and then this will be connected to, say I'll put like this, just you observe this one. Here while writing this, you just put one straight line here. Always it is better to put one straight line, and then here very near to it one cylinder through which when electron beam is allowed, and it will be coming out of this as a collimated beam, and this beam is made to incident on one nickel target. that nickel target and when it is gets scattered, and so it will be scattered like this. When it is gets scattered here, one rotatable detector will be there, rotatable detector on which we have one microscope like this, one microscope we are taking, and so for the microscope we are connecting it to galvanometer. This is a galvanometer. Here this has been connected to one potential difference arrangement here. See, just the figure is like this. It has been connected to this. Again, this is connected to this one here, and here one high tension battery will be connecting. This is some high tension battery. This has been connected like this. If you want, you can take like this only, no problem. This is just you take it in this way, and this should be connected to this. This you call it as high tension battery. Here this is the detector with a, this is a detector, rotatable detector, and as well as this is nothing but a nickel target. It is a nickel target, and this is a cylinder, and so this is the electron beam. This is diffracted beam, and this angle is nothing but theta. This is the filament. See, like this, and of course this is an evacuated chamber. Overall, it is an evacuated chamber we are taking. This is an evacuated chamber. Now you see, after writing the figure, you see, just like in biology, okay, you'll be writing very neat figures and all. Here write like this, this will be enough. All the parts must be there. Say there is an electron gun, this part completely with this filament and as well as this cylinder, we call it as electron gun. What is electron gun means? Which emits electron beam. So now explanation. Arrangement consists of nodi idhe reethine barire. Arrangement consists of an electron gun. Electron gun means, I told, which emits electrons. See, here there is a filament. That filament, when it is heated and it is coated with barium oxide, when it is coated with barium oxide, when you heat it, electrons are emitted. Electron beam will be emitted. And this is connected to some high tension here. This is connected to positive potential. This acts like an anode. See, here electrons are emitted and they are attracted by anode. And when they are passed through that cylinder, the beam which is coming out here, it is called as collimated beam. What do you mean by collimated beam means? Very simple, it is a parallel beam. That parallel beam is made to incident on nickel target. When it is made to incident on nickel target, that nickel target scatters the beam in all different directions. Now in one direction we are keeping one movable detector, and we are analyzing, we are connecting it to galvanometer. And entire arrangement, this arrangement has been kept in an evacuated chamber. See, once again here, arrangement consists of an electron gun, if you want a nickel target, and a rotatable detector with a galvanometer also, rotatable detector with a galvanometer. Now when electron gun is connected to low tension, this completely system is only electron gun, and that is between electron gun and anode cylinder we have connected one high tension battery. Where electrons are emitted by this electron gun, they are passed through a cylinder and made as a collimated beam, and that collimated beam is made to incident on nickel target. Nickel target diffracts the beam, that is a scattered one, diffracted beam. It diffracts the electron beam. And so now what we do further, and everything has been kept in an evacuated chamber. Now what we do here, we fix up one particular angle theta. For an angle theta, we will increase the voltage, that high tension voltage, from 44 to 68 volts. We will observe the intensity. That intensity of radiation is detected by the galvanometer. If galvanometer shows deflection, there is an intensity. And when we observed that, there will be some peaks. See, just like in diffraction pattern, you will be getting some peaks like this. In the same way, exactly at 54 volts, there was a peak. So we have observed this peak. This peak is given by light only, when light undergoes diffraction. Now electron beam is also giving a peak. What is the meaning of it? electron also undergoes diffraction and electron beam exhibit. We can conclude that electron beam exhibit wave nature. See once again here, this diffracted beam, we are studying the diffracted beam and intensity of the diffracted beam recorded here we are studying by keeping angle constant and again by changing volts. For different angles also, even exactly for 54 volts at theta equals 50 degree, there will be one peak will be observed. That peak refers to diffracted beam. When that is referred to diffracted beam means, it also behaves like a wave. And again from this diffraction experiments, we got lambda as calculated. This experimental value was turns out to be 0.165 nanometer, 0.165 nanometer. See now, theoretically this is experimental value. Theoretically if I use the same formula like 1.227 divided by root V here, root V. If you take V as 54 volts, we are getting 0.167 nanometer. Isn't it? This value is experimental value and this value is a theoretical value. Both are in well agreement. Okay, that is excellent agreement. So, final conclusion is electron beam exhibit wave nature. And so, this is about Davison-Germer experiment. What you have in this complete chapter is this only. Say, what I have spoken is, what is electron emission, types of electron emission, what is photoelectric effect, describe an experiment to demonstrate photoelectric effect, and then what are the experimental facts about photoelectric effect, all these things. In the previous episode, I have explained. Today, what I have explained is, like I started with Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect, how to write it for 5 marks, and then some concepts here, it is like dual nature of matter, what is exactly dual nature of matter, and then how to get the de Broglie wave equation, what are the different types of wave equations, how to show that electron exhibit wave nature. See here, one more point is, let us see that Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, see here we are talking about all these things in the point of almost examination point we are talking. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. You have studied this even in chemistry also. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. What it states is, just you put like this, delta x into delta p equals, we write h cross. That is nothing but delta x into delta p is nothing but h by 2 pi. What we say here is, both moment, that is, accuracy in position and as well as momentum cannot be measured simultaneously. This change in position and change in momentum cannot be measured accurately simultaneously. If there is an error here, and if you are measuring this accurately, there will be error in delta p. That only we write it as delta x into delta p equals h by 2 pi. And even further also we say this is h cross is in a different way they will take. This they will put like this is h cross by 2 and h by 4 pi they will be taking. As of now you just take this delta x into delta p for your standard, delta x into delta p equals h by 2 pi. With reference to competitive exams, one more you should remember. Say delta e into delta t, this is also we write it as h by 2 pi. What is the meaning of it? That is, change in energy and change in momentum again cannot be measured accurately and simultaneously. If one you measure properly and the other one, there will be more error. And so this has been actually explained even by Born's interpretation also. That is also, if you want just touch that Born's interpretation. See, in case if I say delta p is 0, what do you mean by delta p is 0? Lambda must be constant. Momentum is constant. Delta p is constant means delta x must be infinity. When delta p is constant means here, that light should have a definite wavelength. When it has a definite wavelength, it will be spreading all over. So, according to Born also, he was telling like, it will never have definite value. It is like a wave pocket. So, in that way, he has confirmed this Heisenberg's uncertainty principle also. But you try to remember this, Heisenberg's uncertainty principle is delta x into delta p equals h cross. Now, dual nature of matter and radiation, theory part matra nodideve. In mundukke sulpa problems ondu eradu mooru problems ontara hege barutte exam alle yav rite answer maadbeku anta torustina nanu bari chapter taruvadre 5 marks complete alla theory plus 5 marks ond problem nodkondre nimge compulsory 5 marks irutte adralli ಅದರಿಂದ ಒಂದೆರಡು ಮೂರು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬರಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಈಗ ಒಂದೆರಡು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ನಾನೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಸಲ್ಲ, ಹೌ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನೋಡಿ, ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇ ಕೆ ಆರ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಇದು ಈ ಥರನೂ ಬರ್ಕೋಬೋದು ಫೈ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇ ಕೆ. ಎವೆರಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿವಾಲ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅಂದರೆ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ನಾಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ. ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ, ಒಂದು ಕಾಮನ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸೇವನ್ ಎ ಮಾನೋಕ್ರೊಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಮಾನೋಕ್ರೊಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಮಾನೋಕ್ರೊಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಸಮ್ 4000 angstroms ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಮಾನೋಕ್ರೊಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ 4000 angstrom ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಎ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 1 electron volt. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದೆ ಮೈಟ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಒನ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನೋಡಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡಾಟಾ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ. ಈ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಮೊದಲೇ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸು ಕೇಳೋ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದೇನೇ, ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆದರೆ ಯಾವ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ನ ನೀಟಾಗಿ ಹೋದರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಡಾಟಾ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಯಾವ್ದು ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ರೆ. ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ, ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಇದೆ, ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ, ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು ಇ ಕೆ. ಇ ಕೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ. ನಾವು ಸೇ ಇಫ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಇ ಕೆ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೈ ನಾಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ. ಟು ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ದೇರ್, ಯು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ 6.625 × 10⁻³⁴ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 6.3 × 10⁸ ಸಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆಸ್ 4 × 10⁻⁷. ಸೇ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ 4000 angstroms. 4000 angstroms ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆಸ್ 4 × 10⁻⁷ meters. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೌಲ್ಸ್. ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಂಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ, ಸಿ ಬಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿನಾಮಿನೇಟರ್ ಯು ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಬೈ 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೈ 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಸೇ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ ಇ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ ವಿ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ವಿತ್ ಯು. ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ದಿ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಫಾಲೋ. ಇ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಪುಟ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇ ಕೆ ಆರ್ ಫೈ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇ ಕೆ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇ ಕೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್? ಇ ಕೆ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಇ ಮೈನಸ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ, ಇ ಮೈನಸ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ. ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಸೇ ಹಿಯರ್ ದರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್. ಯು ಗಾಟ್ 12.42 × 10⁻⁷ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ 4 × 10⁻⁷. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಡೂ ಓವರ್ಆಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 3.105. ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟರ್, ಯುಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 3.105 electron volt. ನಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 3.105 electron volt ಮೈನಸ್ 1 electron volt. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ 2.105 electron volt. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಆಸ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಲ್ ಬಿ ಎನಫ್. ನಾವ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಇಫ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್, ಯು ರೈಟ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ ಇ ಕೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ½ mv² ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ 2 e k / m. ಇನ್ನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಬರೀ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್. ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ 2 e k / m, ವಿ ಇಸ್ √2 e k / m. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, 2 × ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ 2.105 ಇಂಟು 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಜೌಲ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವೆಲ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ಜೌಲ್ಸ್. divided by 9.1 into 10 power minus 31. Now, to make calculations quite simple here, you can make it like this. It is, you just find out first powers you take out, 2 into, don't do anything, just 2.105 into 1.6 divided by 9.1. You'll know daily, minus 31 minus 19, minus 31 if it goes to the numerator, it will become 31, and minus 19, 12, take it out of the root, it will become into 10 power 6 meter per second. You calculate this and put the value. And after finally putting the value, don't forget to put the unit. Always you have to put the unit. If you don't put the unit, again it will be a problem. Okay, you will be losing one mark. So this is how you have to do it. Now one more type in this. Let me say they will give threshold wavelength. Observe this. Threshold wavelength will be given. Lambda will be given. Again same thing. They will ask you to find out Ek and velocity of the liberated photoelectron. Say lambda naught is, let me say around 6000 angstroms. Lambda naught. And lambda is around 3000 angstroms. You see here, as lambda is less, energy must be more. You are all aware of it. As lambda is less, energy must be more. So here, by using lambda naught, nevo W calculate made, HC by lambda naught. Just as I shown earlier, you put like this only, 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 multiplied by 3 into 10 power 8 divided by lambda naught is 6 into 10 power minus 7 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Calculate the value. Similarly put, E equals HC by lambda. Again, what is kinetic energy? Ek equals E minus W. And then you will get that value. And then get back to this, V equals root 2 Ek by M. This way you try to do. This is one of the important problem I am telling. There will be many, many other problems but there. You have to do it. And further, in dual nature of matter and radiation, problems are very, very simple. See here, what after all they can ask is, by using this formula, one is lambda equals H by MV and another one is lambda equals H by root of 2M Ek and again lambda equals H by root of 2M Eb. These are the only three formulae which we can make use. Now one problem, let me say, I say like a particle of mass 1 kilogram, a particle of mass 1 kilogram is moving with a velocity of, say, a particle of mass just 1 kilogram moving with a velocity of around 6.625 meter per second. One simple example I am taking. What is the de Broglie wavelength associated with it? I had given M, I had given V. What is lambda now? Lambda equals H by MV. You have to write the formula. And after writing the formula, substitute 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 divided by mass is 1 I am taking and velocity I am taking it as 6.625, that's it. And then what will be the answer means 10 power minus 34 meter, lambda is 10 power minus 34 meter. Now you see, I had given 1 kilogram here 6.625, that might vary. And another possibility, what is the de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron when it is moving with certain speed, whatever might be the speed. Let me say again, something like this only I will give. Some 6.625 into 10 power 6 meter per second. 6.625 into 10 power 6 meter per second. Then again, lambda equals H by MV. H by MV. 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 divided by mass of the electron. It will not be given. 9.1 into 10 power minus 31. And of course, sometimes in the paper, generally, general instructions there only, whatever is required they might give, or otherwise you try to remember mass of the electron, you should remember. 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 multiplied by 6.625 into 10 power 6, just the 6.625 cancels and then this will be 1 by 9.1. do this calculation into powers you do and put it as meters, that's it. And again, any electron again accelerated through a potential difference, if I give, we can't use this formula. I can't use this formula, I have to use this formula only. Already I told lambda equals, I can go for 1.227 by root V. If I give V, substitute for V and you will get the answer. If I give kinetic energy, take mass also into consideration. And again, one more I told, like proton and alpha particle, if I give, which will be having less wavelength and which will be having more wavelength depends on this formula 2mqv when they are accelerated through same potential difference, and all those things we can do it. In this way, if you want, many other problems will be seeing. And nimge iga ee chapter mele swalpa problems saha touch madidene. ಈ ಸಂಚಿಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಮುಗಿಯುತ್ತೆ. ಇನ್ನು ಆಟಮ್ಸು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮುಂದಿನ ಸಂಚಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಶರಣು ಶರಣಾರ್ಥಿ.
ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ಸಿಡೇದಹಳ್ಳಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು. ದೂರವಾಣಿ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ 9845477404. ಜ್ಞಾನದೀಪ.